Swiss Alps High Altitude Farming moving towards Sustainability Group 7. Switzerland is located in the bootleg of Europe with a growing population of 7.9 million people. Because of this population, the Swiss are currently developing a new form of agriculture called high altitude farming.
Switzerland has an average household disposable income of $30,000 per year, with 79% of people being employed. With that being said, the top 20% of the population earns about 5 times more than the bottom 20%, creating a sharp economic divide in need for sustainability.
The Swiss government is made up of 7 members elected by the Federal Assembly. The Assembly then takes turns acting as the president. As for the infrastructure of Switzerland, a large portion of government funding is spent here. This domain gives approximately 14 million Swiss francs for the use of things like road construction, irrigation, agricultural engineering, construction, and projects for regional development.
High altitude farming requires efficient transportation and roadways to travel up and down the mountainous regions. Therefore, the push for improved infrastructures is vital.
Swiss farmers receive far more government subsidies than do U.S. farmers. The framework of agricultural policy is based on a subsidiary system that is financed by the Swiss Confederation and implemented by cantons, which would be called states in the U.S., with 3 domains of support from the federal government. Domain of direct payments is the largest percentage or amount paid out to the farmers. There are 3 types of direct payments, which include general direct payments, ecological direct payments, and ethological direct payments.
Most of the fresh water that is used in the Swiss Alps comes from runoff of the melting glaciers or melting snowpacks. This is why the Swiss Alps are known as the water towers for Europe. Most of all of this water is used for irrigation.
37% of Swiss landscape is alps, meadows and pastures, crop fields, vegetable fields, fruit plantations, extensive fruit tree orchards, vineyards, and ecological compensation areas for agriculture.
There are 2 types of markets, niche and agritourism. Niche markets are subsets of markets on which a specific product is focused. A market niche defines product features aimed at satisfying a specific market needs, as well as price range, quality, and demographics.
The land is spotted with livestock throughout, with 9,390,000 poultry, 1,580,000 cattle, 700,000 of these being cows, 1,580 swine, 420,000 sheep, 90,000 goats, and 60,000 horses. Switzerland has one of the most progressive animal protection laws. This includes the use of battery cage, hormones, and antibiotics in breeding are banned. Animals must be able to graze, and farmers are not allowed to remove horns or tails in the animals for any reasons.
The largest form of energy being used is hydropower, which makes up 60% of Switzerland's energy sources, the other 40% of which comes from nuclear power plants. This includes many dams in high altitude regions that may require off-site coal-fired power plants to pump water into reservoirs that reach a greater distance.
The large Swiss Alp mountains can make it difficult for farming in Switzerland. In these areas, a 3-phase production system is used.
In the winter months, valley farming is implemented at the bottom of the mountains. This is similar to the United States farming. Livestock are housed in stalls because of the large amount of snow that falls from the mountains. The livestock are fed similar diets as in the United States with grain, supplements, and forages such as hay that is grown on the farms. If it is a dairy livestock, the cow is milked twice a day and the milk is sold as fresh fluid milk.
During the spring and autumn months, pasture grazing is implemented in the middle of the mountains. Livestock are let out on the pastures to graze throughout the day. For some farmers, they let their livestock out for many hours and put them back into the barn at night. However, some farmers leave their livestock out all night. Also, the livestock are fed grain, forage, and supplements similar to the United States.
During the summer months, high alpine pastures are implemented at the top of the mountains. 3 out of the 4 seasons, Swiss high altitude farming is very similar or identical to the United States farming. The difference comes in the summer months. These high alpine pastures are very nutrient rich for the livestock. In this way, farmers can feed less to no grain, forage, and supplements. When it comes to June, the cattle, sheep, goats, and other livestock are walked up to the top of the Swiss Alps on foot by the farmers. This process can take up to 3 hours because you can't bring trailers up on the narrow, rough, and curvy roads of the mountains.
A celebration parade takes place as the people watch as the livestock walk through the village streets decorated with elaborate, expensive, and large bells. This is done in June when the livestock are walked up the mountain and in August when the livestock is walked down the mountain. Swiss tradition for you when you get married is that you receive one of these large cowbells to put on your livestock. Livestock spend 3 months on these high alpine pastures.
Once on top of mountains, the elaborate bells are switched out for basic bells. These bells are used to help keep predators away and so that the farmers can find their livestock easier. If it is a dairy livestock, a mobile parlor is brought up or a permanent parlor is built to daily milking twice a day. The milk, instead of being sold as fluid fresh milk, is usually made into Alp cheese. Farmers with dairy livestock go up to the mountain every day. However, if they have beef cattle, sheep, or goats, they are left up on the pasture with periodical checking on by the farmer.
Finally, when the livestock leaves for the high alpine pastures and meadows, the farmers turn their attention to hay making for the winter months. The farmers have already planted the seed in the spring, so by the time they get to the summer, it will be ready to cut. The hay is cut, then stored in bins and given to livestock in the winter months.
Sustainable agriculture encompasses the three pillars of environment, economics, and social structures that set standards for conserving land use and products gained from the resources produced. Collecting farming practices that follow quality environmental standards while keeping economic profit and social equality for laborers will overall produce a more sustainable society in Switzerland.
Looking to the future, one aspect that must first be assessed is the growing number of people below the poverty line. Poverty is a growing issue, with only 79% of employed people being from ages 15 to 64. This is largely due to the decrease in number of farms. From 1965 to 2005, the UN reported a decrease of 60%. In order to increase the jobs and increase the overall economic status of Switzerland, the government must implement a policy that ensures farmers steady prices from the resources that are produced. This will create a stable market base so farms can keep up in a competitive industry and grow in size to employ more people.
Importing of goods has also become a sustainable issue in Switzerland. The total amount of products produced and used in the country have fallen from 40 to 60%, with farmland still covering around one-fourth of the land, mainly in the mid to low valleys where civilians also live. Changes can be made in how or where the Swiss farmers choose to grow crops and raise animals that will help an impact on sustainability as a whole.
High altitude farming is best for a rotating system between grazing in the summer and growing hay in the winter. The hay that is grown in the winter is harvested and as feed for the animals. This is the best use for pastures that cannot be normally used to house larger crops like corn or wheat. Conventional farming is similar to the way that we farm and commercially in the United States. Conventional farming is used in the Swiss Alps mountain valleys. Conventional farming is a necessity to keep increasing internal products.
Organic farming helps with the overall environmental impacts of pesticide use in the Swiss Alps valleys. This will create a smaller amount of chemicals left in the soil, which will promote increased amounts of harvesting in the future. High altitude, conventional, and organic farming are all being implemented today and are providing the Swiss culture with different farming options.